Apostle Clifford Daniels here on a Friday night, and it's hot, it's humid, but guess what? I'm alive and well, and so are the ones who finna tune in. We running a little late, had a situation that I had to take care of in the name of Jesus. We got that cleared up, and we thank God for you, whoever is going to tune in and watch this now, and whoever's going to tune in later and watch it. For those who are going to tune in on Channel 18 and watch it, we thank God for you. Amen. You too. Either way, you're going to be blessed tonight. We want to say thank you, and we thank God for you tonight. We want to look at John 7, chapter 7. We want to talk about belief. We want to talk about believing. Amen. 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 We thank God for you. We see people are tuning in. We're running a little late, like I said. And don't forget, I'm looking up and down. I'm looking at this camera here in front of me, and I'm looking at, I got two other cameras in back of me. So excuse me while I'm doing this and that. But let's get in the Word here. Let's look at John 7 and look at our base scripture, 37. John 7 and 37. Jesus said, can I say what Jesus said? I'm not saying what the preacher said, because the preacher can only say what Jesus said. All things are possible to them that believe. Everybody say that with me who watching this. Ready, go. All things are possible to them that believe. Everybody believe. I believe in God. Well, do your beliefs turn into action? When I believe in eating a gallon of ice cream, not a half, that five, what is that thing, that big tub? I'll put a dent in that thing. We don't need to get in a bowl. The container was a bowl. You know how you used to get the munchies? See, I know some Hagel talking like that. Let's be real. I wasn't saved all my life. I get the munchies, I eat the whole thing. So what I'm trying to say is that when you believe, you're going to have some action to show your belief. Just like God said he loved us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. When you love, you give. When you love, you give. Love is an action word. Listen, let's get this verse here. I'll read it from the King James first. It says, John 7 and 37 and 38 and 39. We're in that last day, the great day of the feast. Jesus stood and cried, if any man is thirsty, let him come unto me and drink. Listen to what Jesus said. He didn't say go to happy hour. He didn't say he'll go some for the brothers ain't here. He didn't do that either. He said, come unto me and drink. Why did he say that? Here we go. This is the key verse that we're going to key in on. He or she, this is not a chauvinist statement. He that believes on me, you see the tense in the King James, it's believeth, means continuing to believe. Right here in the Amplified, it says, he who believes in me, who adheres to, trust in, and rely on me. Whoa. So how do you believe and just believe and do nothing without relying on what you believe? What I believe is my bread and butter. What I believe is, you know, when you believe something, you feel secure, you're anchored, you're confident. Why? Because you have gotten results from what you believe. And every believer who is a believer should have gotten some, what can I say, benefit from what you believe. Shouldn't we? Amen. Which made me believe even more. Which made me just throw caution to the wind and say, this is what I've been looking for. I drunk of what Jesus was offering. I ain't thirsty no more. I drunk what he was serving. Yeah, what? Matthew 5th chapter in the Beatitudes said, he that is hungry and thirsty, amen, shall be filled. Blessed is he that is hungry and thirsty. All right? So, look at this. He that believed on me, as the what? Scripture has said. He that continue to trust, he that continue to obey the word, put it to work in their lives, shall, what? Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Why did he say water? You talking about drinking something now. He's talking about the Holy Ghost. See, when the Holy Ghost, when you drink of the Holy Ghost, you ain't thirsty no more. It's too many professing people say they believe and chasing and thirsty and hungry for something else. I admit, when I was hungry and thirsty, guess what? I hadn't tasted what Jesus was offering. But I was eating and drinking off the devil table. The Bible said you can't eat off the devil table and then partake of the Lord table. That's in the book. So, but when I tasted what the Lord was serving, all of a sudden, the hunger that I had was filled. The thirst that I had was quenched. What did it? What I was trying to do, fill that void where God belonged, when I put Jesus, accepted him as my Lord and Savior, and put him there, I became fulfilled. And it's sad that a lot of believers hadn't put Jesus in his proper place. Now, why did the scripture say? Now, let me get 39 to clarify 38 and 37. But this he spake of the Holy Spirit. What, the rivers of living water? Yes. He was speaking of the Holy Spirit. Yes. He was speaking of the Holy Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because Jesus had not died and risen. So he couldn't send back the Comforter because he hadn't died, but he was speaking. All who would believe will receive this river of living water when they receive the Holy Spirit. Now, what is this saying? What is this telling us? What is this saying? Do you? Well, let me ask all of y'all a question right here who know me, who's been a part of Kingdom Faith, who's watching this. Do your leader believe what the scriptures say? You can answer. You can answer that. Do I believe? Do I preach something that I don't believe? Do I serve you something that I don't eat? You know, I ain't one of them cooks that cook stuff and get everybody to taste it, and I won't eat. I'm not one of them. So, what about your belief? What about your faith? Jesus said, all things are possible to everyone that believes. It said, with mankind, it is impossible. For not with God, for with God, all things are possible. See, somebody who know the Lord should have been like, yes, yes. See, when I hear that scripture, it's like, man, I'm ready to do battle now. All things are possible. I got that in my spirit, Jeremy. That brings me joy, Tina. No matter what comes up in your life, that situation you were talking about, all things are possible if you believe. You don't struggle with that. I don't struggle with scripture because I'm a believer. Only people who want to debate struggle with scripture. I believe what the scripture said. Do you believe? Well, I know the Bible said that. He said, love your enemy. Well, see, we struggle with that. You got to love your enemy. Didn't Jesus love us when we were his enemy? I was an enemy to Jesus because I wasn't helping the church. I was a fool. Amen. So let's talk about this. Let me get here in my lesson here tonight. Amen. We pray and trust that you will believe. Let's go back over some things. What is the Greek word for believer? It's 4103 P-I-S-T-O-S. Here go the definition. See, when you believe, Jeremy, can you pull up John 3:16 for me, please? Pull that up. So, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Why? Why did God give his only begotten son? To die in Clifford Daniels Sr. place. Wow. That proved his love for me right there. For God so loved the world. Let's get a little personal. He died for the, he died for Jeffrey Dahmer. He died for the Ku Klux Klan Imperial Wizard. He died for Byron Beckwith, who killed Mega Evers. He died for the man that shot JFK. He died for the one who killed Martin Luther King. Do I need to keep going? He died for those people who put the hoses on the blacks back in the day, who stopped them from voting, who hung the blacks in the wood, cut their testicles off and put them in their mouth and raped the black women. He died for all of those people. What are we going to do? See, saints, this is God's soul love, and his love is equal. It's on a level playing field. And if we're going to be like Christ, then we got to love like him if we want to get in the kingdom. So, right here, pull that up, Jeremy, for God so loved. How it described how our Heavenly Father loved. He just didn't love, he so loved the world. Wow. And we're celebrating a holiday that God gave the world a precious gift. Wow. A precious gift. God bankrupted heaven to give the world the most prized possession he had. It was his son. That he gave his only begotten, only mean unique, because he was born without a daddy. He didn't have sperm. God put himself inside of Mary, begotten son, that whosoever continues to believe in him should not perish. Why did he say? He didn't say you wouldn't. He said you should not. Because guess what, saints? You can stop believing and trusting in God. Something can happen, catastrophic, hardship. I've seen it happen to people. If God loved me, why did he let that happen? Why it had to be God? Why couldn't it have been Satan? Why do you want to attribute that calamity to God? Why? And I've seen people walk away from God. Well, matter of fact, let me turn over here to John 6:63. Turn over there, Jeremy, John 6:66. There's a lot of people turned their back on Jesus, but I'm asking you, the race is not given to the swift nor the battle to the strong, but those who endure to the end will be saved. I want you to take your faith in Christ and you go, and you go, and you grow, and you grow, and you grow, and you hang in there. Yes, it's going to be hard. Yes, anything worth having. Jesus said, if you suffer with me, you're going to reign. Now, there's some suffering involved. You ain't going to be like following Jesus. Everybody's not going to love you when you give your life to Jesus Christ. I can tell you that. My life has been everything that God told me it was going to be. From that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. They got offended. Jesus said something. Jesus said something. He said something that really cut them to the heart. They got offended and they turned and left Jesus. Let's see what Jesus said. Go to the next verse, Jerry. We talked about believing. Your belief got to turn into faithfulness. Go to the next verse, 67. Then Jesus said to the 12, after those disciples, see, Jesus had more than 12 disciples. He had two staffs of 70, and he had a full-time staff of 12. He had part-time disciples that didn't travel with him, but these 12, that was the inner circle. Let's see what he said. Then Jesus said unto the 12, that's Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Peter, James, Bartholomew, and all the rest, will you also go away? You gonna lead too? I want y'all to notice something. I want you to notice something. Did Jesus run up behind these disciples who turned their back and walked them over Jesus? Where y'all going? Please don't leave me out here. Ah, don't leave me. I need you. No, he did not. He let them go. And when I've had people threaten me, and I know pastors have had people threaten them, I leave. Okay, and what I supposed to do? If they did Jesus like that, I'm not going to beg nobody to stay where you don't want to be. Amen. See, this is why you got to be called to certain ministries. All right? Jesus asked them, are you going to leave too? Let's see what the answer is. Then Simon Peter, the one who was quick at the draw, answered him, Lord, Master, to whom shall we go? Wait, if you or me or Brother Jeremy or Big Cat or Mary or anybody watching this leave Jesus, I'll tell you to whom you're going to. Hey, but what somebody you going back to? His name's Satan. You're going back to your old master. Jesus said you can't serve two masters. And guess what? I ain't going back there. Because that sucker tried to kill me. And he tried to kill you. I thank God that God called me and put his hands on me to stop me from self-destructing. I'm like Peter. To whom shall we go? Listen to what Peter said. Thou hast the words of eternal life. And if we're going to have eternal life, you're going to have to hang in there, saints. You're going to have to hang in there. So you can't leave and abandon. Jeremy, I'm finna fast forward. The Holy Spirit keep pressing me to go to Matthew 13. We got to go here because these four types of souls are proved out. It was four types, and three of them only one soul proved out. Only one of these were believers out of the four. Can I ask a question? Is it one out of four people that are true believers looking at this ratio right here? So it says, verse 18 from Matthew 13. Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower. Okay. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not. Wait a minute. Let me ask y'all a question. You who belong to Kingdom Faith, do anybody leave here without getting understanding? You can answer that. You can put a response there. Nobody leave here without us breaking his word down, going thorough, being thorough with it. It's just like you cracking the nut and giving you the nut. Don't hit the nut, eat it. We took the hard stuff away from around it. That's what a good parent does. Jeremy, don't give Jyree no steak. Do not give him no licorice. What are you going to do? Gum it? He's going to throw up. He can't handle that. So a good pastor, a good leader, a good teacher is the Holy Spirit. He takes the hard stuff away from around it. So everybody can leave with what? Understanding. So guess what? Anyone who hears the word of God of the kingdom and understand it not, then cometh the wicked one, Satan, and snatches it away, that which was sown in the heart. Wait a minute. It got in the heart, but you couldn't process it, nor could you digest it because it was sitting on the top in the surface of your heart. Okay? Verse 20. But he that received the seed in the stony places. What you mean? Let's read. The same is he that hears the word. That hears the word. Do you hear me? And immediately. Amen. Immediately. He received the word into stony places. The same as he that hears the word. And immediately with joy he received the word. He receives it. Wait a minute. He received the word. 21. Yet he has no root within himself, but endures what? For a while. No, the Bible said the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. But those who endure to the end will be saved. But listen to what the Bible said. He has not root within himself, but doeth for a while. For when tribulation and persecution arises because of the word of God, by and by he is offended. He leaves. These guys over here in John 6:66, they got offended and left. Haven't you seen people get offended? They don't quit their job that easily, do they? But they'll leave the church. I'm leaving. What are you really leaving? You'll be there when you get wherever you're going. You can't outrun you. Amen. So your belief just don't stay belief. It turns into faithful. You become reliable. Amen. In the usage, the word believer in the Bible, the usage of it is you are trustworthy, faithful, because you are believing. Wow. Wow. So, number one, trustworthy, faithful, faithfulness of a person who shows themselves faithful to the commands of the scriptures. And then we also got the root of 4103, P-I-S-T-O, faithful, and 4100, P-I-S-T-E-U-O, faith are the same as referring to persuasion. Are you persuaded that Jesus is Lord? Are you persuaded that Jesus died for your sin? Are you persuaded that God is able to keep you from stumbling and falling? Or do you believe that God is able? Are you persuaded? I'm fully persuaded. And can't nobody change my mind. See, saints, you don't just believe and don't grow to where you fully persuaded. Okay, thank you, Holy Spirit. Jeremy, pull up 2 Timothy, please. 1 and 11 and 12. And I'm going to get it from the Amplified. See, I like how the Holy Spirit just pulls scriptures up. That Holy Spirit is a teacher. Amen. Amen. We thank God for you. Joe Nickbone Nathan said, I can't count the time where I wanted to run away from God because I got offended with the word. Amen. Amen, Joe Nathan. See, the truth going to set you free. Reason why I know Joe Nathan is free because he just spilling the beans on himself. See, he free. A person that can talk about himself, that open, Joe Nathan, you can help other people, because when they see that, they're like, wait a minute, if Joe Nathan can get like that, who you think he is? It's going to be more of a, like, I know he ain't got, I know if he can get it, I can get it. Well, whatever it take. We want whatever it take. Come on. Where unto you, I am appointed a preacher and an apostle and teacher. We at 2 Timothy 1 and 11 and 12. Listen, whereunto I am appointed a preacher and an apostle, a teacher of the Gentiles. Okay? Okay? For the which cause I suffer these things. Paul went through some stuff, y'all. Nevertheless, I'm not ashamed. Watch this. For I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Y'all ain't with me right there. Y'all need to get with me right there. Y'all need to get with me. I'm persuaded. I'm persuaded. Put that back up there. Put that last one up there. For which cause I also suffer these things. So the hardship, Tina, you're going to have to endure sometime. It's worth it. Jeremy, Big Cat, Mary, Bernadine, some of this stuff that we're dealing with, this is the call. I love God. So if Christ went through, who am I? You know, I heard a commercial the other day, and I hear people say this, and nobody has ever heard me say this as long as I've been saved or pastoring. December the 31st will be 33 years. Well, don't kill you, make you stronger. That ain't true. That ain't true. How much more stuff, saints, y'all who listening to me, saints, listen to me. How much more do you need to go through to be strong? You ought to be a spiritual Hulk. You ought to be Superman. You ought to be a Hulk. You ought to be Shazam, Rock, what all these Captain Marvel people? I don't watch the movie. What are they? What all these, the Avengers coming together, Wonder Woman, all these superpower people. You ought to be a spiritual giant. All the hardship we done been through, all the tribulation and pain, how much more it gonna take to get you strong then? So we know that ain't true. What tribulation do? Look at Romans 5 and 5. Tribulation worketh patience. It builds endurance so you can stay on the race. You can keep running. You can keep running. This is a marathon. This ain't no sprint. But I love this verse. And now, but I want you to get this now. I suffer these things. For which cause I suffer. Nevertheless, I ain't ashamed. Are you? I'm not a secret agent Christian. Everybody knew what Daniel was about. There go clips. Some used to call me Daddy back in the day. Some used to call me some of everything. I had all kind of nicknames. But guess what? I wasn't ashamed of who I was. Everybody knew I was a smoker. I mean, I smoked every day. I could smoke all day. That's what I did. I was about it, about it. I was about it. Now that I'm saved, I'm about the will of God. Amen. Do you hear me? Amen. Wake me up at 3 in the morning. You're going to get a sermon. You don't care. Don't ask me no question. I'm a preach. It's in me. I can't help it. Why? Because I'm persuaded. Come on. Watch this. I am not ashamed. I need some saints that ain't ashamed. There was a song out back in the day when I got saved back in the 80s. Are you a closet Christian hiding your faith? No, I ain't no closet Christian. I ain't going to tell y'all everything because you'll be looking at that preacher did. Yeah, I did it. I sure did. I'm not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed. Do you know who you believe? Do you know him? And am persuaded. This is what belief turns into. This is what faithful turns into. This is what the Greek word, the root word of faith and believing, this is what it turns into. Persuaded. You become persuaded. Put that back up there. I am persuaded that he is able, and God is able to keep. God is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Now, what have you committed to God? Have you put yourself and committed yourself to him? Well, if you have, guess what? You're persuaded that he can keep you. Is that true? Okay, but what about the ones hadn't committed themselves? What about the ones that ain't commit? You 1 minute you're for Jesus, next minute I don't know. That's the white man Bible. And 1 minute I'm for Jesus, I'm going through. Jesus get you out, I'm back with the world again. You need to make your mind up. Hot or cold, lukewarm, he said he'll spew you out of his mouth. Come on, saints. We can't do that. Are you fully persuaded? Are you fully persuaded? I am. I'm fully persuaded. Why so many people don't know? Well, I don't know about that Jesus thing. I met a guy today in GNC. somebody asked me about a scripture. We were talking about soul ties. And they said, hey, we didn't see that in the Bible. I said, it's not. But you can find it. They found it, 1 Corinthians 6. He that become one with a harlot, you're tied to a harlot. So, you know, and they went on and said, well, but the person said, well, my husband said Christ died for that, so that's wiped away. I said, go plant some corn and see what corn come up. I said, even though Adam and Eve sinned and messed this world up, we still affected by what Adam and Eve did. Because we say, don't deny the fact that we got to deal with the fall. We just ain't struggling as much. As we learn God, we realize that we don't have to toil anymore. But the young man walked in. He said, y'all ain't talking about the I am that I am. Is. And wait a minute now. He had them big old dread. Well, he had a mask on. And wait a minute, Saint. I'm like, wait a minute. I ain't talking about that black Jesus in Revelation got that hair like lamb wool now. And I was checking him out. He said, no, I ain't talking about him. I'm talking about the great I am. I said, I got you. But I kept proceeding to want to know. He wasn't one of them Hebrew Israelite people. So come to find out, he was talking about the same God. But he pulled his mask down, and he got a grill full of gold. And the brother full of the Holy Ghost. Now, that didn't shock me. He had these long dreads, mouth full of front, top and bottom, grill gold. But the brother know Jesus. He wouldn't be wanted in a church, would he? They wouldn't want him in there. But Jesus said, I have sheep that are not of this fold. I pray I gave that joke a high five. He said, man, what's your name? And it's just a blessing to see that brother knowledgeable. I didn't ask him what church he need to go to, but we agree. I told you, Jeremy, when you got the Holy Spirit, there ain't a lot of friction. It ain't a lot of friction with people who got the Holy Ghost. It's those ones that don't have the Holy Ghost. You see, it's always tension, always. And this is where you get that tension from in the church because everybody want to hear that Jesus stuff. Well, I come for the choir. Singing ain't never saved nobody. You get your heart prepared. So have you committed? Let's stop right there. What have you committed to God? In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he'll direct your path. Commit thy, it was another, wait a minute, see, I know it's there because the Holy Spirit led me there. If I go to the Amplified, it'll be there. But let me get over here. Let's move along. Let me get the Amplified right here. Saints, I hope this is blessing you because it's blessing me. Jeremy, go to Hebrews for me, 11. And one, we're gonna go there because we're dealing with faith. But saints, you got to develop your belief. You just can't say you believe. James said the devil believes also. So I want to know, is the devil faith or is it belief that came from knowing who God is? Verse 11 says, wait a minute, what's 2 Timothy 2? No wonder. Let me see. This is why I suffer as I do. Still, I am not ashamed, for I know him, and I am a person, and I am personally acquainted. I am personally acquainted with him whom I believed with absolute trust and confidence in him. This is the Amplified. And in the truth of his deity. Yes, he is the Messiah. I am persuaded beyond any doubt that he is able to guard that which I have entrusted unto him that day when I stand before him. Did y'all hear that? Did y'all hear that? I am fully persuaded. When are you going to get persuaded that God is able to keep you if you commit yourself? I'm not struggling with no pandemic. I never have. I know the pandemic is real, but my faith is not in the pandemic. My faith is in the risen Savior. I know it's a fact. People are dying from it. People are getting vaccinated for it, but I'm not denying it's not real. But my faith in God is more realer than my faith in COVID. And I believe, and I'm fully persuaded, that he's able to keep, because I have committed myself unto him. And that's where I want kingdom faith, and that is why I want all of you who are listening, you got to develop your faith. Come on. Hebrews. We're going to be through here in a minute. We started late, and I hate I did, but I had to apologize for that. Now, faith is. Faith is always in the now. If it's tomorrow, Jeremy, it ain't faith. I'm healed now. I went to the doctor. Doctor looked at my knee. They x-rayed it. And I spent a lot of money going to the doctor. That was a specialist. So my insurance only covered so much. Oh, they kept making me appointments. I said, Lord, by the time they do see me, this knee going to be healed up. Anyway, the doctor took my knee and went to working with it. But always confessing, I said, Lord, let it not be nothing that show up on that x-ray. And barely something did show up. It was. They went by the MRI that they did, and they looked at what they saw. But that specialist took my knee and was bending it. He moved it and do this hurt, do that hurt. Nothing hurt it. My knee ain't hurt it since. But it did. I haven't hurt it. But I confess that I was healed way back when I hurt it. But God told me to be patient, because what I did to it, it just wasn't going to be one of them healings that happened overnight. Now, God have healed me point blank, but some healings, like I had a fungus in my fingernail. I believed I was healed when I prayed and confessed, but it took some months and years for it to heal up. One day I looked, I'm like, wow, gone. It was gone. So I know, saints, this is what I'm telling you. You got, if it ain't now, it ain't faith. Well, I still see some symptom there. Just because you feel a symptom and see some evidence of what you believe in that you hear from, let me ask y'all a question. Do it make the word of God void? Do it make the word of God alive? Because bad as my knee were hurting, I kept saying I'm healed. The pain didn't take the power out of the word. I told the pain, so I had to keep telling myself, by his stripes I'm healed. The devil said, you lying. No, you a lie. I kept speaking the truth. By his stripes I'm healed. Is that the truth? Is that the truth, y'all? By his stripes I'm healed. So, oh, I'm hurting so bad. The pain may tell you you're not healed. Pain ain't telling me. The word told me I'm healed. Pain don't nullify the word of God. It usually get bad before it get worse, don't it? I mean, before it get better. Some things get, notice how when you make a dentist appointment, you were hurting. Soon as you make the appointment, your teeth stop hurting. You ever had that happen? Jeremy, you ever had that happen? Yeah, I have. So, put that back up there. Now faith. What you believe in God for? If you don't believe you have it now, then it ain't faith. Now faith is the what? Substance of the thing hoped for. Wait a minute. How can you have faith for something God didn't say you can have? Let me ask a question. Is that out of order? You can answer, but I can tell you real quick. It's out of order to believe for something God's word didn't say you can have. What's your substance? Watch this. Every one of you all that's watching this broadcast said, y'all coming by my house and you're going to clean it, you're going to rake my leaves, and you're going to light my grill, and you're going to barbecue at my house tomorrow. Every one of y'all coming. I'm believing that. Only problem with that, I don't have a word to put my faith on. So what proof do I have to go on? God ain't said nothing. What are you basing your faith on? Say, well, Jeremy, you going to wash my car? I ain't hear Jeremy say that. Reggie, you going to do what? You going to walk? You want to go walking tomorrow? We going to do 10 miles? Reg ain't said nothing. Jeremy ain't said nothing. Y'all didn't say you were coming to rake my yard. You didn't say you were coming to clean my house. So why would I ever believe that? Why, oh, why, oh, why? I don't have a word to put as substance for my reason to believe. But let me tell you one thing, baby. God done spoke. Yeah, I got reason. I got substance. Because the word is the substance of why I believe. God said it in the story. I know we can't get with that. Like, what is he talking about? Now, the faith word. God said you're healed. God said, I love you. God said, I'm going to bless you. God said it. If God said it, I can anchor down and believe what he said. But if God didn't say it, Big Cat said he was going to give me $2,000. Big Cat, when did you ever say that? So why would I believe that? But God said that by his stripes, you're healed. God said, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefit, who healed you of all your diseases. See, I can believe for healing because the word said it. I can believe that if I give, it's going to be given back to me. I believe if I do the golden rule toward you and everybody in this sanctuary, guess what? It's going to be done back to me. Hallelujah. I can set my faith on that, but a lot of people don't have substance. You don't have anything to base it on. I'm praying. Prayer do not change God's mind. Prayer aligns you with what God has for your life. Now I'm finna share something with you. I'm gonna go a little further. And we finna close here. God has already predetermined how much and how far he's gonna bless you with how much. Everybody. I don't care who you are. When you pray, it ain't gonna get God to add to what he wanted to do for you. It only going to line you up with what God already has for you. Your prayer should align you with the will and what he's already allotted for you to have. It ain't going to increase what God got for you. It's just going to line you up so he can start releasing it to you. It's not finna, I don't care how hard you pray. You ain't finna change God's mind. Prayer lines the believer up with God's will. And God is able to do abundantly. And see, what God got for you will blow our little mind. And you think, well, I want to be. You can't handle what God got for you now. I double dog dare you to start praying for God's will to be done in your life. For you to align your life up with the will of God. God saved you for himself. God didn't save you for you to do what you want to do. Amen? So, come on, Jeremy. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things, what? Unseen. I don't have to see it to believe it. Come on, verse 2. For by faith the elders obtain a good report. If you read the whole chapter of Hebrews, it'll talk about Rahab. It talked about all those old people in the Old Testament who started off rough. Abraham didn't start off good. A lot of them didn't start off good. But it's how they ended. You might have had a rough start. Who hadn't? But guess what? Guess what? If you stay with it, it gets better. Come on. If you stay with it, saints, it gets better. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the what? Faith word of God. So that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Tell people, when you talk to people, the Lord took nothing and made something. He took dirt and made man. He took earth and made flowers. He took earth and made cattle. He took the earth and made fish. He took the earth and made fruit trees. Everything he made from something. So where did this terminology come from? He take nothing and make something. He'll make a way out of no way. Sorry. That's erroneous teaching. That's not biblically sound. Come on. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God testified of his guilt, and by it he being dead yet speaketh. What Abel did is still speaking, because we're talking about it tonight. Come on, give me five. By faith, Enoch was translated, and he should not see death. It was not found because God translated him, took him on up. Now, his flesh didn't go up in the kingdom. The flesh fell away. Well, where did he go? That ain't none of my business. God didn't put it in the book. I ain't trying to figure it out. That's a question I don't even need to know. I'm a faith person. I'm not a private investigator. Amen. I don't need to dig into that. The scripture is enough for me. He wasn't found. And if God wanted him found, you would have knew, all of us would know. But that ain't none of our business. We'll know when we get there. We'll know when we get to the kingdom. He was not found because God had translated him. That's enough for me. For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. How? Because he walked by faith. You don't please God without faith. Here we go. Give me this one. And we're going to wrap this up. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. What is faith? Faith is the same as being persuaded. Are you persuaded? Are you persuaded? It's the same. So if you don't have faith, you cannot please God. It is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe. Must believe that he is a rewarder, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Now, I'm going to get this from the Amplified, that verse 6. You got to believe. You're going to have to believe. Simply put, Hebrews 11 and 6 from the Amplified. Everybody need an Amplified Bible. I sent my cousin Steve one in Milwaukee. I wanted him to have one. Amen. Listen, but without faith, it is impossible to walk with God. It just ain't a lot of people walking with God. Amen. How do you walk with God? With faith. Without faith, it is impossible to walk with God and please him. For whoever comes near to God must necessarily believe that God exists. Wait a minute. When you don't believe and have faith, you don't believe God exists. Wow. You don't believe. You say you believe. But your belief hadn't turned to work. James said faith without works is dead. Let me finish this so we can close out. But without faith, it is impossible to walk with God and to please him. For whoever come near to God must necessarily believe that God exists. You got to first believe that God exists and that he rewards those who earnestly and diligently seek him. A lot of people don't get rewarded because they don't earnestly, honestly, and diligently seek him. They seek his hand. What you got to put me next, Lord? Never mind. I won't go there. Okay, seek him. Okay, so moving along. So we got a trustworthy and faithful people who show themselves faithful to the commands of the scripture. That's what we were talking about Wednesday night. The Greek word for, the Hebrew word for here is, wait a minute. I don't want to lie. The Hebrew word for obedience means shama. Is shama. It means to hear, to listen, to give attention, to understand, to submit, and obey. So if you're hearing the word of God, just to shout on it and not to apply it in your life, that's not good, saints. So my words to you, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believeth means we got to continue. Let's continue to study the Bible. If you got a church, if somebody may happen to watch this and you're not in a ministry, or your ministry hadn't opened up, praying as God to send you somewhere. You need to be back. Don't forsake the assemblies of saints. Amen? So, saints, don't stop believing and trusting in God. Amen? God reward those who earnestly, honestly seek him, seek his face, not his hands, not what he want to give you, but seek a relationship. Walk with God. And as you walk with God and have faith in God, it's easy to get along with other people. It's easy to flow with other people. Amen? Until next time. Saints, continue to build your belief that it turns into faith, faithfulness, trustworthiness, reliable. That's what your believing turned into. It becomes loyal. You become loyal to God. Amen? Not only will you be loyal to God, you'll be loyal to your job, to your supervisor, to your spouse. You'll be loyal. You'll just be a committed person. Amen? Until next time, this is Apostle Clifford Daniels. We pray that you were blessed in the name of the Lord. Be blessed. Find a church Sunday worship service and attend. Don't have to be here. If you don't have a church family, go somewhere where you can attend and be blessed. In Jesus' name, until next time, we love you and be blessed.